Hi, I'm Chaplain William Johnson from the Spiritual Care Department with our Monday morning meditation. It is such a privilege, as always, to be able to share with you in these Monday morning meditations because they are designed to inspire us and encourage us as we journey along. Today is a very special day as we prepare ourselves for the week. We want to remind you that you are loved, appreciated, and you're irreplaceable. To all of our care staff, to all of our supportive organizations, for all those in the community, for our families, for our patients, for our doctors, for our nurses, for our caregivers of every stripe, for those who serve us food, and for those who protect us on these grounds and around us, for all that you do, and those who make sure that we are okay when we check in and make sure we're okay when we check out, whatever you do. Thank you so much for all that you do. Now, for our Monday morning meditation, this Monday morning meditation is entitled Ubuntu. Ubuntu. I'll get to the meaning of that term in a moment, but I want to share this story as we open up this discussion. There's a story about two brothers who were on an urgent journey. In fact, their father was ailing, something terrible, very sick. And one of the brothers had a dream of a potion that would cure his father. The other sat down and listened closely to the dream and drew up a map in order to find the potion. And though they weren't sure where to begin on their journey, they were hopeful that they would get there and be back in order to save their father's life. On the second day of their journey, it became cold and windy as they reached the foot of the enormous mountain, the story goes on, and they had a steep climb. The brother who had the dream said, "I'm certain we need to travel this way." And the other brother, second brother, strongly disagreed and rejected him and said, "No, don't you see, we're supposed to go that way." And while they argued back and forth, each of them forgot that they needed each other in order to make the journey complete. The map calls for them to be able to know and work together. Needless to say, neither one of them survived, and neither one were ever heard of again. And in fact, the story never tells what happens to their father. What's interesting about the story is that it leads us and leaves us at a place where we're wondering what the end of the story would be, but I think we do know that often in our journey, we come into places where fair weather and fair havens don't always remain. We discover that even though we have the best of intentions as we begin our journey, we also realize that conflict and strife, difficulty and hardship sometimes come into the picture and disturb us on the journey. What is interesting here in this story is that it happens to us more often than not, when we fail to realize that we need one another and we need to work with each other along the way, which brings us to the term Ubuntu. It's a South African term that reminds us that these things are true. It's deep, it's important, and it says this: I am because you are because I am. I am because you are because I am. The brothers had forgotten that each of them working together made for the whole. And so it is in our society for sure that many forget that we need each other, that I am because you are therefore I am, is an important piece for everything in creation. There is no way to breathe air without the trees breathing first. And there's no way to have trees without our breathing next in order to allow for the trees to thrive. So what happens if we cut down all the trees and we, in essence, really cut off that which gives us air? So it is in our relationships with one another, and so it is with our relationships with ourselves and more importantly, our relationship with God. That we are in this place together. That there is this interwoven, very important fact that we are all one, one with the other, and there's no way to hurt one of us without hurting ourselves. So I encourage you, as you are navigating, keep the mindset or the thought process of the South African proverb, Ubuntu. I am because you are. You are because I am. As you journey today and as you think of these things, be reminded that while we are navigating difficult terrain, we need each other. We really do. We need each other for support. We need each other's intuition. We need each other's invention and all the things that we bring to the table. We need one another. And by doing that, and by recognizing that we need one another, we are more apt to respect one another. So let me talk about that just for a moment. What it would look like to have Ubuntu be a way of life. What it would look like to me is that we would find ourselves in a place where we respect one another, we honor one another, and we offer dignity to one another. Respect, honor, and dignity. Everyone deserves those things in life. Respect. You know, Aretha Franklin sang a song, R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Find out what it means to me. In other words, to have respect means that I take into account the value of your life. I take into account that you have worth. I take into account that you have something to offer. And therefore, I don't take it for granted. I respect who you are and the gift that you are in the world. Respect, dignity, and honor. Dignity is that thing that I saw a picture once with an eye, looks like an eye, and then inside the eye was this image of a room and what the person who was the viewer looked like to themselves. It was a depiction. I was in Winnipeg, Canada, and at a conference about palliative care and hospice. And the reminder for us was that often the people that we see and encounter are trying to see themselves through our eyes. In other words, they always want to have dignity. Dignity so that they can feel like they belong. Often in our world, people are often pushing people aside and leaving them without dignity. All people really want is to have some degree of dignity, not only in life, but also in death, that reminds people that they had something to contribute, something to offer to the world. It's important to be able to hold those things in tension. I have something to say. I want others to know I have something to say, and I've made my mark on this earth. We are aware we won't live forever, but while we're here, we want to make sure we hold on to dignity. Dignity, respect, and now honor. Well, most people think honor is that in which we offered to those, unfortunately, who are soldiers who have earned the right by their valor to be able to be honored in some special way for some extraordinary feat. But really, everyone deserves honor. What honor means is that it is a recognition of what a person contributes to the whole. Ubuntu calls for us to recognize what all of us bring to the whole. And there is no way for us to be who we are without the value, the insight, the encouragement, the empowerment, the investments of other people. None of us are here without someone giving us something, doing something for us, sacrificing to some degree on our behalf. And because of that, we all deserve honor. Well, what does God say about honor, dignity, and respect? Well, I am convinced that the Bible or whatever your faith tradition is and religious background or faith community has something that speaks to all of these things that make us what we are. What is true is Ubuntu calls for us to see the other as ourselves. I honor you because I honor me. I respect you because I respect me. I offer dignity to you because I believe I deserve dignity myself. There's no way to not treat you with dignity and not become undignified. There's no way to be disrespectful and not disrespect myself. There's no way to be in a place where I am dishonorable to you and not dishonor my own being. We are tethered one to the other, and we live in this world created by the one who tied us together under one thought, that we are Ubuntu. I am because you are. You are because I am. Let's work that way throughout the hospital this week and know that no matter what our task is, no matter where we're from, no matter what place or role we have, what capacity we offer our gifts in this place, we are still in this larger world, offering ourselves in this one theme of Ubuntu. Ubuntu. Make sure I say that right. Ubuntu. It is a blessing to be able to share with one another. Thank you so much. Have a great week and have a great day. Remember, as I began, you are loved, you are appreciated, and you are irreplaceable. Have a great week.